One of the questions that was asked to me on our comments here on YouTube was, people ask me, when you go out fishing, how do I understand when I'm riding down, I'm about to go launch my boat, or I'm going to my boat slip, how do I determine like where and how I'm going to fish and what should I fish? And, you know, of course, that's a lot of information, but I'm going to kind of cut it down a little bit for you. Instead of doing a video of me fishing and stuff, I'm just going to kind of show you what, tell you kind of what's going to go on. So while you're riding down, the things that you should be doing, like I do in the mornings when I'm riding down, is first of all, you need to know which way the wind direction is going. And then the other thing is you need to know what way the tide is moving. And a lot of times, you know, people look at tide charts, but now with USGS.gov, they pretty much got these little stations that are like weather stations, but it shows like salinity, what the direct tide is, what is the winds at the time, what direction is the wind from. All of those things are on that website. If you go to USGS.gov and look it up, you can probably find some of those in your area that are near the launch that you're going to fish out of. So like I fish out of Hopedale. So what I do is I look at two of them. I always look at the one that's down in a place called Bay Gardein, and then I also look at the one that is up in a place called Crooked Bayou. Most of that's on the Delacroix side, but the reason why that is that those two stations, they're probably 20 miles apart, but I can kind of see what the tide is actually doing, because sometimes out at Bay Gardein, which is right by the Gulf, that water could be coming in, but up by Crooked Bayou, it could still be falling. And if I'm on a falling tide pattern for the last few trips that I've taken out, I want to go over to that area. I don't want to go down in the incoming tide area because I've got a pattern going right now. But for you as an angler, if you're going out, you're going to go ahead, you're going to pull up to the launch, you find out you got an incoming tide, you got a northeast wind, and you know, your salinity is better down south than it is up like in the marsh, you may want to opt to go down there because the salinity is better. Then you know you got an incoming tide, you've seen it on the chart, you go down there. And then what you do is the winds tell you kind of where you can fish. I don't ever, hardly ever fish leeward banks. Most anglers try to get on the leeward bank and they try to fish along it, but it's hard because when you're trying to cast into the wind, it's just really, really tough. And there's no reason to put yourself through trying to cast. The line goes over the cork a lot if you're fishing the cork. It's just really tough to fish that way. But what I would do is I would always, as I'm riding out, I'm thinking of places that might have lots of broken up marsh or a lot of islands in the area, to where if I got an island here and an island here, I can get in between them. Then the wind that's blowing, it doesn't affect me inside of this little area between the islands, and I can fish there on the windy bank. The wind won't be, you know, I won't have chop all over the place. It'll be nice and calm in there. I always fish with the wind to my back. Now, selecting the spot, what I always like to do is I always like to start at points that have current. I will go out, I'll go around, I look, if I find me a point, I'll get on the up current side. So whatever side the tide is going, if it's, let's just say the point's right here in front of me, that's falling tide, this is incoming tide. Well, I want to be on the up current side of that. So that means that if it's a falling tide, I want to be on this side. If it's a rising tide, I want to be on this side. So you just want to be up current to where when you throw your cork or your bait, it's going with the tide around the point. You don't want to be on the backside like in the eddy. If you were fishing rainbow trout, total different story. But inland fish, they like to be on the upside. That's the side they want to be on. So you want to be on the upcurrent side. So what you have to do is think in your mind, where can I fish an upcurrent side point with the wind to my back? So you have to think about it. If you don't know it, bring a map with you. Standard mapping. We'll have a link on here. Standard Mapping sells maps pretty much for everywhere, and they're aerial maps. You can see every single thing on there. And before you leave the launch, you can literally look at it, check it out. Okay, that looks good, this looks good, and this looks good. I'm going to those three spots first. And that's the way you actually learn. Plus, you don't waste a lot of time trying to fish stuff that just really is impossible. Because the thing is that a lot of people think that it's like, spot A, spot B, spot C that Captain Charlie goes to and he goes and fishes. No, I don't do that at all. The conditions tell me where I'm gonna fish and how I'm gonna fish. I don't ever like leave the launch and go like, oh, okay, yeah, I'm gonna go to this spot and this spot and this spot because that's good spots. I never think of it like that. I don't think of like spots. I think of general areas and then I think of the conditions. Once I figure out the conditions, I'll go to main points, then I'll fish maybe coves, and if neither one of those are working, then I'll get up on flats and start working flats. But that's really how I do it. And people ask me all the time, they're like, oh, when I pull up to I'll pull up to a point, and they'll go like, oh, is this one of your really good spots? Everything out here is good. It's just if you find where the fish are and where you fish the conditions correctly, because if you're throwing into the wind and the tide's running back this way, when you throw in and you're trying to pop a cork or use your bait and the tide's coming at you with the wind in your face, you would never be able to set the hook on a fish and get it in time. It's impossible just because you won't have a fast enough ratio reel. It just, things just go crazy. The line wraps around the tip of your rod. If you're one of those guys that the line goes around the tip of your rod a lot when you're fishing, that's because you're fishing leeward banks into the wind. I get that question all the time. They're like, man, I don't understand. I use braid, but it always wraps around the tip of my rod. The reason why it's wrapped around the tip of your rod is because you're throwing into the wind. So when you pop the cork or you jig up your bait, that line makes a little loop and it gets pushed back over the rod and it goes and wraps around the tip. If you had the wind in your back when you popped, it would just keep going. The little loop would just go down the line. So that's a little, you know, a little tip right there. But the thing is that always remember that it's not that there's like secret spots. It's more like you figure out what the conditions are and then fish those properly. And then once you get the wind to your back, you got the tide running across the bank or a point in front of you, you get on the up current side of wherever that is, and then fish whatever baits, popping cork, whatever you want. If that doesn't work, maybe you want to go throw across over some oysters, or maybe you want to get on a flat, or you'll get in a big cove. You've got to change up. Now, the last thing I want to tell you about all of this is that, you know I fish in probably one of the best fisheries in the world. Fishing's very easy here. I mean, it really is. Some days it gets tough. Days like today would be tough for a lot of people. It is bluebird skies, high pressure on us, slick calm. Most people will have a challenging day today. But the thing is that when you come out here, the one thing I want to tell you is that you have to come out, you have to make sure no matter what, that when you come out, you have live bait with you. Make sure if it's there and it's accessible, use it. Do not bring it. I always bring live bait. If you're the kind of person that likes to catch a lot of fish, live bait is the key. Now, if you're an artificial bait fisherman and that's all you like to use, you know that when you use artificials, you don't catch as many most of the time just due to the reason it's artificial bait. It doesn't look as natural as normal live bait does. But you always want to have that live bait as a backup. Sometimes I buy 50, 75 shrimp when me and my wife or my kids are going fishing. We'll fish artificials a lot because I love to fish artificials. But I always have those live bait in the live well because if things are really tough, I know I can just stick a live shrimp under a cork and I'm going to catch something that day. Okay? So I hope this helps you out. Thanks for the questions and the comments. Make sure you subscribe below, and we'll have that standard mapping link on there because that's a really good link. Glenn and them have been at this for years and years and years. He's been doing standard maps from when I first started chartering, and his stuff is detailed. It's got all the names. He even sells a card that'll go in your GPS, and literally you plug it in your GPS, and you have the entire aerial map on your GPS, and it has the trails of where to run, all the common areas that you can run through. So if you're new to an area, that is a great thing. You could get it, and you could follow that little yellow line on his thing, and that, I mean, majority of the time, it's navigable waters. You know, I mean, if the water's really, really low, it might be a little bit shallower or something. You got to use your discretion on that. But that's a really good thing. So check it out. It's called, I know the one I have is called a Louisiana One map, but I think he's got them for all over the coast and stuff. So you have to check it out, okay? So I'll see y'all next time on the water. Make sure you do the comments and subscribe below.